We try one more problem. Let's have. Fine. Fourier series expansion of x is equal to x square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square by 12 in 0 to 2 pi. So that's what we have. Now, let f of x is equal to 3x square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square by 12. Okay. P defined in 0 to 2 pi. So we have L is equal to 2 pi and hence L is equal to pi. So I am always writing L is equal to pi, or I am always trying to find out what is the value of L, so that you will not miss the formula. You will understand what formula we have to use. Okay, and hence we have okay. So we'll have the correct formula, so we can write. The Fourier series expansion of f of x is given as, what we have, f of x is equal to a0 plus summation an cos of nx, n running from 1 to infinity, plus summation here sine of nx and n running from 1 to infinity. Let this equation 1. Okay, so then where what you can have is a0 is 1 upon 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. An is equal to 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi f of x cos of nx dx. And we have dn is equal to 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi f of x sine of nx dx. Okay. So let us evaluate this one by one. Now we consider a0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi. Here this is 3x square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square by 12, and this is, okay, so that's what we have. Now let us evaluate. So I can have this 12 outside, and I'll be having 24 pi integral 0 to 2 pi dx square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square, and we have dx. So let us evaluate this 1 upon 24 pi, and we have here px cube by 3 minus 6 pi x square by 2 and plus 2 pi square into x and 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so we got the integration of this term. You can see if we apply the limit 0, this term will turn out 0, this will turn out 0, and this will also turn out 0. So at 0, all the terms will be 0. only thing we have to consider is what happens at 2 pi. Okay. So let's have at 2 pi. So 1 by 24 pi, this is going to be x cube minus 3 pi x square plus 2 pi square x and 0 to 2 pi. Now let us simplify. So we can have 1 by 24 pi. Then if I put here 2 pi cube minus 3 pi into 2 pi square plus 2 pi square into 2 pi. And at the lower limit, this is going to be 0. So we omit to write that. Now, let us have this 1 by 24 pi. So here we have 8 pi cube minus 3 pi into 4 pi square plus 2 pi square into 2 pi. Now, we can simplify this as 1 upon 24 pi, 8 pi cube minus, this is 12 pi cube, and plus we have 4 pi cube. So you can see this is going to be 12 pi cube minus 12 pi cube, that is going to be 0, and hence we get a0 is equal to 0. So we got here a0 is equal to 0, this equation 2. Now let us calculate am. So we have an is equal to 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi, and here we can have f of x. So the value of f of x, ex square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square pi 12, and this is cos of nx dx. Okay, so we simplify this as, hence an is equal to this 12 pi I can take out, and I'll be having 1 upon 12 pi integral 0 to 2 pi 3x square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square cos of nx dx. So here we get, this is u, this term is going to be v. So once you have u and v, we are able to use generalized bipartite rule. Okay, so let's apply generalized bipartite rule. Okay, so I'll say using generalized bipartite rule, we get. So what we are able to get here, e, an is equal to 1 upon 12 pi. Okay, u remains as it is, 3x square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square, and the integration of cos. So it is going to be sine of nx upon n. Then the next term, the derivative of this term. So we have minus, this is going to be 6x minus 6 pi, and the integration of this term. So it is minus cos of nx upon n square. Now, the next term is derivative of this term. So we'll be having plus 6. And again, integration of this term. So we'll be having minus sine of nx upon n cube. and we have this limit 0 to 2 pi. Okay, now let us see, we know the sine term vanish at the upper limit and lower limit, but please mention it always what you are going to omit and why you are going to omit. Okay, so since sine of 2n pi is equal to sine of 0 is equal to 0, hence we get, what we are able to get is an is equal to 1 upon 12 pi. And here we have this minus term, this minus term will become plus. So we have 6x minus 6 pi cos of nx upon n square, and this term will have the limits 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so let us apply this. This is equal to 1 upon 12 pi. Now this x is going to be 2 pi, so we'll have 12 pi minus 6 pi, and this is cos of 2n pi upon n square. And minus, if you apply 0, what will happen? Minus 6 pi cos of 0 upon n square. So this is 1 upon 12 pi. And we got here, this is 6 pi. Okay, what we know is, since we know cos of n pi is equal to 1, and cos of 0 is also 1. So we get here, this is going to be 1, this is 6 pi upon n square, minus minus, this will become plus. So we'll be having 6 pi upon n square. Now, we'll get this as, this is equal to 1 upon 12 pi, this is 12 pi upon n square, so we get 1 upon n square, and that is an. So we got an is equal to 1 upon n square. Let this equation, so we got the value of a0, we got the value of an, here we got the value of a0, we got the value of an, so we have here the value of a0 is equal to 0 and the value of an. So we got it here as 1 upon n square, and hence an is equal to 1 upon n square. Let this equation. So now we have to find the value of bn. Okay, so let's find the value of bn. Now we have bn is equal to 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi dx square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square upon 12, and here we have sine of nx dx. Okay, so let's have this term. Now here we can take this 1 upon this 12 out, and we can write 1 upon 12 pi 0 to 2 pi. We have 3x square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square into sine of nx dx. So here we got this is going to be u, and this is going to be v. And hence, we are able to use the bypass rule. So we can write using generalized bypass rule we get. So what we are able to get is hence bn is equal to 1 upon 12 pi. So here we have u remains as it is. So 3x square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square, and the integration of sine, which is what we have, minus cos of nx upon n, then minus derivative of this term. So we have 6x minus 6 pi, and here we have minus sine of nx upon n square, plus we have the derivative of this term 6, and we'll have the integration cos of nx upon n cube, and this is 0 to 2. So we can see the integration here, and this minus sign turns to be plus 1. Now, as we know, this sine term vanishes. Okay, so since sine of 0 is equal to sine of 2n pi is equal to 0, hence we have, okay, so bn is equal to 1 upon 12 pi, and this is minus bx square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square into cos of nx upon n plus 6 cos of nx upon n cube, and the limit we have 0 to 2. Now let us apply the limits. So 1 upon 12 pi. Okay. If I apply 2 pi, what I'll have? Minus. So it is 3 into 2 pi square. So it will become 4 pi square minus 6 pi into 2 pi. Plus we have 2 pi square. This is cos of 2n pi upon n plus 6 cos of 2n pi upon n cube. And then we are using lower limit. So this minus minus will turn out to be plus. So this term will be 0. This term will be 0 because x is going to be 0. And this is 2 pi square cos of जीरो अपॉन एन माइनस सिक्स कॉस ऑफ जीरो अपॉन एन क्यूब. एज वी नो कॉस ऑफ जीरो इज इक्वल टू वन एंड कॉस ऑफ टू एन पाई इज इक्वल टू वन. सो वी कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस एक्सप्रेशन एंड हेंस बी एन इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन ट्वेल्व पाई डे माइनस सी दिस आई एम हैविंग 12 पाई स्क्वायर माइनस 12 पाई स्क्वायर प्लस 2 पाई स्क्वायर एंड दिस कॉस इज गोइंग टू बी 1 सो अपॉन एन प्लस 6 अपॉन एन क्यूब प्लस 2 पाई स्क्वायर अपॉन एन एंड माइनस 6 अपॉन एन क्यूब. So this is equal to 1 upon 12 pi. This will be minus 2 pi square upon n plus 6 upon n cube minus 6 upon n cube and plus 2 pi square by n. So we can see that this term will get cancelled with this term will get cancelled with this term and hence, what we have is 0. So, we got n is equal to 0, equation 4. And hence, we have the values of a0, we have the value of an, and we have the value of bn. So, an we have calculated, a0 we have calculated, and if I have a0, an, and bn, then we are able to write the Fourier series. So you can write from equation 1, 2, 3, and 4, we have. Okay, so what is the term that we'll have? We'll have f of x is equal to an is 0, bn is 0. So we'll have summation n running from 1 to infinity 1 upon n square cos of nx. And that's what we got here. So this is dx square minus 6 pi x plus 2 pi square on 12 is equal to summation n running from 1 to infinity 1 upon n square cos of nx. So that's what we can have. Okay. Find Fourier series expansion of f of x is equal to minus pi, minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 0. And this is equal to x, 0 less than equal to x less than equal to y, with period n. Now we'll go for solution. So before we go for solution, now you can see the interval. The interval is symmetric interval minus pi to pi. Okay, and if we have this interval minus pi to pi, then we have to see whether the function is even or odd function. If the function is even function, then our work will be reduced, or we come to know that the function is odd function, then our work will be reduced. So I want you to identify whether this is a even function or odd function. So please tell me whether this is going to be a even function or this is going to be an odd function. This is going to be odd function. Please check the definition properly. Okay, so we have to check the definition properly. Then only we will able to understand whether this is going to be odd function or this is going to be a even function. Okay, let us check whether this is going to be odd function or this is going to be a even function. So what we do to check whether this is a even function or odd function, we replace x by minus x. So first we write, always write what is given to you. So let f of x is equal to minus pi and this is equal to x. So minus pi less than x less than or equal to 0 and 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi. Okay. B, we find in minus pi to pi, then with period 2 pi. So what is the period? The length of the total length of the interval. So 2L is equal to 2 pi and hence you get L is equal to pi. So I got L is equal to pi. This is running from minus pi to pi. So we have to use the formula for the interval minus pi to pi. Now let us check how to understand whether this is a even function or this is a odd function. Okay. So we have f of minus x. When I say f of x, that means everywhere I have x. Okay. When I say f of minus x, that means everywhere I have to replace x by minus x. So let us replace this x by minus x. So I'll be having, this is minus pi. Minus pi less than or equal to minus x less than or equal to 0. And this is equal to minus x, 0 less than or equal to minus x less than or equal to pi. So you can see when I want to find out f of minus x, that means everywhere this x will be replaced by minus x. Okay. But we have to compare this with f of x. So we have to compare this with f of x. So either it should be f of minus time f of x or it should be f of x. So to make this interval in terms of x, what we'll do is we'll multiply by minus 1. Okay. And what we know is, okay, so suppose I have, okay, any interval, okay, a less than or equal to b. And then we multiply this by minus a. Okay. So then if I multiply by this minus a, then it will become minus b less than or equal to minus a. So this is the best thing about the inequality, about the inequalities. Okay. So if we have a less than or equal to b, then minus times b will be less than or equal to minus times a. So that means if I multiply this inequalities by minus 1, I'll have change in this inequality sign. And hence, we get. So we have f of minus x is equal to minus pi when 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi. So we multiply this inequality by minus, then 0 will be here. This minus pi minus will become plus and x will become plus. So this is equal to minus x. This is minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 0. Or we rearrange this function f of minus x. Okay. So f of minus x is equal to, always we start with the given interval from minus pi. So we have to compare it to from minus pi. So it is going to be minus x when minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 0. And this is minus pi when 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi. Now compare this to the given. Okay, so you can see for 0 to pi, what is the value x? What you are getting for 0 to pi? Minus pi. So it is neither x nor it is minus x, and hence we can say this function is a neither even function nor odd function. So this function is a neither even function or nor odd function. So this is neither even nor odd. And if we know that it is neither even nor odd, then we are able to write the Fourier series. So here we have to use the formula 2 of Fourier series, and hence I can say the Fourier series for f of x is given as, so we got here f of x is equal to a0 plus summation n running from 1 to infinity an cos of nx plus summation n running from 1 to infinity bn sine of nx, and this is equation 1. Okay, now what we can have is where a0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. Here we have to be careful for the interval. The interval is now minus pi to pi f of x dx. An is equal to 1 upon pi. The interval is minus pi to pi f of x cos of nx dx, and we have bn is equal to 1 upon pi integral minus pi to pi f of x sine of nx dx. So please be careful while writing the formula. So that's what I always suggest, that you first write the formula for Fourier series, then you write the formula for the coefficients that we want to know or we have to find, and after that we start finding this coefficient. So first we have to go with, consider a0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi minus pi to 0. Here we have f of x dx plus 0 to pi, and here we have f of x dx. So the question is, why do we split this integral into two parts? So the function f of x is discontinued at 0, and hence we have to split this integral minus pi to pi into two parts. Okay, and now let us see what is the value of this integrals. So we got here 1 upon 2 pi integral minus pi to 0. Okay, so in this interval, what is going to be a0? Okay, so we have in minus pi to pi, the value of f of x is minus pi, and 0 to pi, the value of f of x is x. So let us use this value. So from minus pi to pi, the value is minus pi dx, and plus, this is 0 to pi, x dx. So we can have here, this is 1 upon 2 pi, and here this is minus pi x minus pi to 0. This is x square by 2 and 0 to pi. Now apply the limits. So if I apply 0, this term is going to be 0. You are using lower limit, so minus minus plus, and then pi into minus pi. Okay, plus apply the limit. So it will become pi square by 2 minus 0. Okay, and now simplify. So we can have 1 upon 2 pi this is minus pi square, and we'll be having plus pi square by 2. So 1 by 2 pi, this will be minus pi square by 2. Pi pi will get cancelled, and we'll be having minus pi by 4. So we got value of a zero, that is minus pi by 4. Let this equation 2. Okay, so we got the value of a zero. Now we have a n. So a n is equal to 1 upon pi minus pi to 0. So we have minus pi cos of nx dx plus 0 to pi x cos of nx dx. Now here we don't have any problem. In next integral we have to use u into v rule. Okay, and hence what will be having the term using generalized biparts rule. Okay, so generalized biparts rule we will be using for this integral only. This is the easy, and hence we get an is equal to 1 upon pi. So what will be the integral here? This is going to be minus pi into sine of nx upon n, and this is minus pi to 0. Plus for this we'll have x, and the integral will be sine of nx upon n minus the derivative of this term will go 1, and the integral of this term minus cos of nx upon n square, the limit is 0 to pi. Okay, that's what we have. Now what we know is, since sine of 0 sine of n pi, so if you put 0 here it will become 0, if you put pi minus pi here, so it will become sine of minus n pi, which is minus sine of n pi. So this term here, if you put pi it will become sine of n pi, if you put 0 it will become sine of 0, and that we know is 0. Hence we have, okay, what will be having, an is equal to 1 upon pi. So this term is vanishing at both the values. This is the vanishing term, this minus minus will become plus. So I'll be having, this is cos of nx upon n square, and this is 0 to pi. So 1 upon pi cos of n pi upon n square minus cos of 0 upon n square. And since we know that cos of n pi is equal to minus 1 square, so we have here an is equal to 1 upon pi, this is minus 1 square n minus 1 upon n square. Now we have seen that whenever you have the term, okay, if we have minus 1 raised to n plus or minus 1, or 1 plus or minus minus 1 raised to n, then check for n to be even and odd. Okay, so what happens if n is going to be even and n is going to be odd? Okay, so here we have the situation that minus 1 raised to n minus 1. So we have to check what will happen if n goes odd and if n goes even. Okay, so we have, if n is even, then minus 1 raised to n is equal to 1. So this term is 1, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, and hence you got an is equal to 0. Okay, so you got an is equal to 0. If n is odd, then minus 1 raised to n is equal to minus 1. So if this term is minus 1, this minus 1 minus 1 will become minus 2, and we got an is equal to minus 2 upon n square pi. So this is the next equation that we have. Now we have to think of a 0 we got, an we got, then we have to think of bn. So we have bn is equal to 1 upon pi minus pi to 0 minus pi sine of nx dx plus 0 to pi x into sine of nx dx. Again, for this integral, we have to consider u into v rule. So we can write using generalize by parts rule, v gate. Okay, so what we'll have here, bn is equal to 1 upon pi. For this we have minus pi of nx upon n and 0 to pi. Minus pi to, and this is minus pi to 0. Plus, for this we have x remains as it is, minus cos of nx upon n, and then minus, the derivative of this term is going to be 1. This is minus sine of nx upon n square, and this is 0 to pi. So what we know is, since sine of 0 and sine of n pi will have the value 0. Hence, we have, okay, so what is the value of bn we will have here? So bn is equal to 1 upon pi. This is going to be pi cos of nx upon n minus pi to 0 plus, this is minus x cos of nx upon n, and this is 0 to pi. Okay, so let's have this value. So 1 upon pi, we'll have, this is pi into cos of 0 upon n minus pi into cos of minus n pi upon n. Here minus pi cos of n pi upon n, and plus, we'll have here 0. Because x is 0 here, so this term will go 0. So this is equal to 1 upon pi, this is pi upon n, minus pi, this will be minus 1 raised to n upon n, and minus, this is again pi, minus 1 raised to n upon n. So why this happens? Cos of n pi is equal to minus n. Cos of minus theta is same as cos of theta. So cos of minus n pi will become cos of n pi, and that is going to be minus 1 raised to n. Okay. Now, we can have this pi common. Okay. So, we can have this pi common, pi upon pi, and this is 1 by n, minus, you can have twice minus 1 raised to n upon n. So we can write this as 1 minus 2 minus 1 plus 2 n upon n. So this is bn, and hence we got bn is equal to 1 upon 1 minus 2 into minus 1 plus 2 n upon n. So this is going to be equation. So we get a0, we get an, and we get bn. Okay. So here, what we have obtained? We have obtained a0, then we have obtained an, and then we have obtained bn. So once we have all this coefficient, we are able to write the Fourier series. So from equations 1, 2, 3 and 4, we get f of x is equal to minus pi by 4 plus, okay. So what is the value of an we obtained? Minus 2 upon pi. So this I can write minus 2 upon pi summation 1 upon n square, n is r, cos of nx plus, we can have summation n running from 1 to infinity, 1 minus 2 minus 1 plus 2 n upon m into sine of nx. So that's what we can have, the Fourier series for